Okay, before going into the paper per se, I would like to give my greetings to the distinguished speakers who have spoken before me and to the thousands of people who are watching their screens of these proceedings. Now, I would broadly touch upon only four components and based on which I will be furthering each factor in a little more detail. Now, can I have the screen sharing facility, please? Okay, I will share my screen. Can it be seen?
No, sir.
No.
Sir, first open your PPT and then share screen.
Now it's a PDF, just one page PDF. Is it? Can you see it now? No.
No, sir. We are not visible.
Okay. Yes. Can we see now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We can.
Okay. Now we'll be
yes, now we can see.
We'll be talking about on these four components. So before going into the details of these components, let me give you a brief view on the context from which we are functioning. I represent the Department of ISM, Indian Systems of Medicine, which is considered to be the largest department under AIUSH. And we work along about the primary and the secondary sector of public healthcare service delivery, counting to about 1,200 medical officers from department, 240 to 250 from the AIUSH side, of course from the NAM and NHM component, and the structural and functional unit of the public service delivery in the state of Kerala ranges from the sub-center to the dispensary to the hospitals with 10 bed strength, ranging from 20, 30, 50, 100. So it is through this infrastructure that healthcare service delivery through AIUSH is being delivered along the length and breadth of the state of Kerala. Of course, the tertiary sector belongs to the teaching side. So we have five colleges in the government and aided sector, plus another about 14 to 15 in the self-financing sector. Apart from that, the majority of the public health service delivery is being done through the Department of ISM, and not to mention the valuable contribution given by the private sector also. So apart from giving regular OP and IP facilities, department is running about couple of dozen, in fact, 20 plus different projects ranging from pediatrics to geriatrics. And of course, there are 5 to 6 COVID-related projects that is being delivered from the government-run dispensaries and hospitals. And all our institutions are recognized as Ayurveda clinics from where this kind of public health delivery is being done. So now we will go into the paper proper. Now, component one is software development. The objective of the software development, I have abridged it as CBSS. So it stands for Clinical Decision Support System. So why this special software? The need of the hour is because since we are doing a multitude of tasks in public health service delivery, clinical documentation comes all pervasive and all important. So Ayurveda is, we know, that's very individualistic science. And it's the beauty of it. But at the same time, there is a lot of limitations being individualistic. If we scale up researchers, or high impact research studies, so objectivity and standardization are of pivotal importance, especially with regards to the names of drugs, the names of diseases, the name of diagnosis, the name of diagnostic procedures, the name of treatment procedures, and that varies from state to state. So for the researcher, and to put it up in a high impact journal, these kind of things cause some kind of hindrances and roadblocks. So to tide over that, and we have the eAIUSH component in national health policy and national AIUSH policies, so based on which we can develop a software through which the standardization process of the different terminologies can be done. Once it is done, then we can take on a high impact multi-center clinical trials at different parts of the state, different parts of the nation, in fact, different parts of the globe as well. So it is of pivotal importance to have a software development component. And from reliable sources, it is learned that the erstwhile state of Andhra Pradesh, this kind of functioning has been done in its nascent stage. So now it has been split up in Simandra and Telangana. So we can get cues from that particular state and to scale up to the required level. The Department of AYUSH, Government of India can take this up and scale it to a national level so that the researchers can be very, very much benefited. Now, as the second component called major policy decision is needed. Why? Because all of the earlier speakers was speaking about importance of Ayurveda and very often in the public health sector scenario, though the Government of India has given much importance to Ayush in general and Ayurveda in particular, so many states are not reflecting that kind of enthusiasm and that kind of support that the central government is providing. But to tide over that, if Ayurveda has made a national system of medicine, all these things, all these what do you call the lethargy from the different state governments in accepting Ayurveda in toto as a complete system of medicine rather than in the complementary and alternative form can be devoid of. So for that, there should be a decision from the state government, from the central government to recognize Ayurveda as a national system of medicine and to put it into the union list. See, the importance of the union list is that because we have Indian Railways, we have Indian Armed Forces, we have Indian Space Research Organization, we have the Indian Army. So just like it, if we have the Indian systems of medicine put on the union list, so we have three lists. The union list, the domain consists entirely of the matters which is decided by the government of India. Then we have the state list under which comes the hospitals, dispensaries, health. The domain is under the state government. And we have a concurrent list where the stakeholders are both the central and state governments. The medical profession is under the concurrent list, whereas the hospitals, dispensaries, trade works, everything that comes under the state list. But if we can transform, we can relocate Ayurveda from the state list either to the concurrent or to the union. I would prefer it to be in the union list so that if the government of India comes up with a proposal or comes up with the statute or comes up with a policy or comes up with a law, that can be equally applied to all states, all 28 states in union territory. So everything that how we want to envision Ayurveda, how we want to showcase Ayurveda, how we want to strengthen Ayurveda into the 21st century, the whole vision of the central government can be put it across the nation in one single step. For that to take place, a major policy decision is needed. But I think that is possible because the early speakers were talking about the medical pluralistic legacy and integrated practices which we have. And he was linking the Ayurveda component as the civilization legacy. Yeah, of course, Ayurveda is a part of our legacy and our rich treasure, rich heritage. So to preserve and protect that rich heritage in its full time purity is the integral role of every government. And it is the national treasure of our nation. And it is, if once it becomes a national system of medicine, then there is no stopping from Ayurveda becoming the primary system of medicine. And of course, at this juncture, I would also stress upon one other point that we need to shed that CAM tag from Ayurveda. That is, it is not complementary or it is not alternative. In fact, it is the mother of all systems. So that kind of importance has been given to this system of medicine. But unfortunately, this enthusiasm of the central government has not been reflected to different state governments. And for that to change, major policy shift is decision is needed. And that major policy decision can come as if Ayurveda is made the national system of medicine and that particular branch of medicine is being put on the union list. Another thing is the different policies which we have in this regard. We have the national policy on health in 2017. Earlier, we had the Indian systems of medicine policy on 2002, and now we have the National Education Policy 2020 and National Commission on Indian Systems of Medicine 2020. So all these policies have the objective, if we closely look at it from different close quarters, we have that all these things are one thing in common, that is the mainstreaming of Ayurveda from a standalone to three-dimensional aspects and appropriate integrative practices, taking into consideration of the medical pluralistic aspect of our country. So three-dimensional mainstreaming means the mainstreaming of Ayurveda at the primary, secondary, tertiary levels, at the concept level, at the process level, and the product level. So how can we do that? But we can do that by improving our HR component, improving our infrastructure, improving the delivery aspects. And so as I have told you earlier, since Kerala is going to be the cradle of Ayurveda, cradle of genuine Ayurveda, where the penetration of Ayurveda is so deep, almost in all sectors of health. But even then, in the state of Kerala, the full-fledged recognition of Ayurveda is not being given. But maybe due to some other reasons, but we all know, but the main reason is the stiff opposition from the conventional modern medicine aspects. And to tide over this policy shift, though we have a state Ayush Health policy 2016, that has not been even looked into by the state government. So though the political support is always there for Ayurveda, from time to time, from different governments, that kind of support is not been ensured from many a time from the bureaucracy. So for that to tide over, we need appropriate legislation based on these national policies. So if Ayurveda is put under the union list, all these things can be very easily tied over. So I would suggest that three-dimensional mainstreaming of Ayurveda with appropriate integrative practices, and the opposition and the resistance in recognizing Ayurveda as a mainstream medicine should be made very minimized, or should be made null and void if we adopt appropriate strategies and policies, of which putting it into the union list and proclaiming it as natural system of medicine will go a long, long way. Now, another thing is the business process re-engineering of the existing system of public health service delivery. We know in the state, I will cite the example of Kerala, we have in Ayush, under Ayush, we have six independent directorates, of which ISM is one, Director of Ayurveda Education is one, State Medicine Plan Board is one, Aujadi is one, Director of Homeopathy is one, and Principal Control Office of Homeopathy is one. So six independent directorates working under one Ayush, the six independent field directorates working under one centrally functioning directorate. But then the administration becomes so cumbersome. So if we shift from the directorate system to the commissionerate system, so independent decisions can be taken within short notice, and the level of vertical communications can be brought down to a simpler level. Moreover, one commissioner can take independent decisions and respond, and several joint commissioners who can be given, several joint commissioners who are of certain subject-specific experts from different fields of Ayush, and they will be reporting to a commissioner who is from the general administrative cadre, and who will be then reporting to the secretary Ayush at the state level. So administration and service delivery will be quite easy. So these four components, development of software, because I have told that EIF is an important integral component of the National Health Policy 2017, and to have a standard procedure for all the terminology, it is of very...
Dr. Murugan, can you make it fast? Dr. Murugan, can you make it fast? Time is running fast. More than 15 minutes now.
Okay, I will try to make it fast, but I started only 10 minutes back, but the early speakers were taking for 15 to 20 minutes.
Yes, so it's not repeat that. Okay then. Okay. Make it fast, that's all.
You want me to go fast and wind up soon, is that so?
Just have the points. More than elaborating, okay. Have the points. You got the points.
The points you can see on your screen, and yeah. I don't want to, since someone has intervened, I will tell that these are things which I want to say, so please take this serious note of it and represent it in appropriate authorities. I wind up my talk. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.